Hello everyone, in this video we have one chord circle, one semicircle, and point B is given center of the chord circle, and point C is given center of the semicircle, point E is given tangent point, and this length is given 11, here is given 5. The question is, what is the area of the triangle ABE? First of all, if we connect these 2 points, you know that here is 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. And let's draw one perpendicular line from the center onto the chord, like this. You know that chord will be divided into 2 equal parts, right? So these 2 parts must be equal. 5.5, right? After that, let's draw one more perpendicular line like this. If you notice that, we get a rectangle, right? Let's call here point K and here point T. So KTEC is a rectangle. After that, let's call here alpha, here theta. Notice that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees. So here must be equal alpha, right? And here must be equal theta. If you focus on this triangle have same angles, and you notice that opposite sides of the 90 degrees are same, right? That means these 2 triangles are congruent. Therefore, if there's a 5.5 opposite of the theta, must be equal 5.5. And if here is 10.5, that means this length must be equal 10.5, right? Then, if there's a 10.5 opposite of the alpha, must be equal 10.5. So, if it is 5.5, that means 5 units left here. Therefore, the area of the triangle ABE is equal height is 10.5, right? Height times base over 2. So base is 16 over 2. So, if you simplify the expression, 8, therefore, the area of the triangle ABE must be equal 84 units squared. Okay. This was the first method. Now, we will calculate value of the area using second method. First of all, let's connect these 2 points again. And if we connect point F and point C like this, here must be equal 45 degrees, right? Why? Because we know that here is 90 degrees, right? And if we complete the chord circle to a full circle like this, this arc must be equal 270 degrees, right? So, angle AFC must be equal 135 degrees. That means 45 degrees left here. Then, if you focus on this triangle, we get an isosceles right triangle. So, here must be equal 5 units. After that, if we connect these two points, these are also radius, right? Therefore, BFEC is a kite, right? So here is 90 degrees. After that, if you focus on the triangle, if there's a 5 units, opposite of the 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees, must be equal 5 root 2, right? You know that these two parts are equal because of kite. That means these two parts must be equal 5 over 2 root 2. Here is also 5 over 2 root 2, right? Okay. We know that this length is also radius, right? So if you focus on this quadrilateral, r squared plus r squared equal 16 squared plus 5 squared, right? Why? Notice that if we connect these two points, this triangle and this triangle, these are the same height patterns, right? Okay. So 2r squared equal 256 plus 25. That means r squared equal 281 over 2. Right. And then if you focus on this triangle, let's call here M. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, M squared plus 5 over 2 root 2 whole squared equal R squared. We have calculated R squared as 281 over 2, right? That's right here. So M squared equal 281 minus 25 over 2. That means M equal 16 over root 2. So M is going to be 8 root 2. That's right here. M equal 8 root 2. Therefore, the area of the triangle ABE, if we use sine formula, 16 times 10.5 root 2 over 2 times sine 45 degrees, right? Why? If you notice that, angle AEB must be equal 45 degrees. We know that sine 45 degrees equal root 2 over 2. So if you simplify the expression, that means the area of the triangle ABE must be equal 84 units squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye.